And that is where Edward Snowden is and if we're ever getting him back. As you know, he's applied for asylum in Ecuador. And Ecuador is basically laughing in the U.S.'s face over this, saying, we don't care whatever pressure you want to exert on us. That's fine. Go ahead. We have our own process and we're not going to listen to you, big bully.
Yeah. No, and the contempt, the raw contempt from the president of Ecuador for the United States and for the Obama administration really striking. Reading this morning, I'm thinking, wait, wasn't electing Obama supposed to make the rest of the world like us and respect us? Even that hasn't turned out to be true.
Yeah, and in fact, the president of Ecuador, Rafael Carrera, we had heard people go, well, you know, Ecuador gets a lot of U.S. aid. Well, that guy right there, the president of Ecuador, said, we don't need your stinking money. You can't tell us what to do. You're not the boss of me. And things to that effect. He later kind of backed off, nonetheless. But it just goes to show you, my, how the mighty have fallen. Yesterday, the president was there in Africa, and he did do that joint press availability where he was asked about the Snowden case, and Snowden is still holed up at the airport in Moscow. The president seemed to many to be like, wait a minute, they've changed their narrative again. Now they're backing off. Rather than talking about how he's an NSA guy or a government employee, instead he's boiled down to simply a 29-year-old hacker. Here's the president. Listen.
I have not called President Xi personally or President Putin personally, and the reason is because, number one, I shouldn't have to. This is something that routinely is dealt with between law enforcement officials in various countries, and this is not exceptional from a legal perspective. No, I'm not going to be scrambling jets to get a 29-year-old hacker.
And some have suggested the reason he refers to him as a hacker rather than as an NSA employee or anything else like that would be to simply distance him from the government.
Well, he didn't hack into government computer systems to get this information. He was employed by intelligence agencies and had access, legal access to this information. Boy, that's the most arrogant display I think I've ever seen from this
president. But what he's trying to do is he's obviously trying not to elevate Edward Snowden.
They already did that. They elevated him earlier, and now they're kind of backing off from it.
Well, it's hard to know how important Edward Snowden is. I mean, if he
is the world's
most wanted man, or if he is a 29-year-old with some sort of beef. I mean, you hear what the president's doing. He's trying to say, like, this is a kid who's a hacker. Yeah. The president isn't going to engage on that level. But it's tough when all these other countries are basically, like, flouting U.S. law.
Sure. It's also tough for the president of the United States to say, okay, this guy who is regarded by many as perhaps the most significant leaker or whistleblower in history, I'm not going to pick up the phone and talk to other people about it. But when you look at some of the other people the president has called, not related to this case, but you saw a couple of days ago, he called the Prop 8 plaintiffs out in California with the same-sex marriage thing. Sandra Fluck, after the Rush Limbaugh thing, NBA player Jason Collins, who came out, the Philadelphia Eagles, after the owner after signing Michael Vick, and that pitcher for the Perfect Game. So it's interesting. The president has time to call all those people, but he can't pick up the phone to try to get his hands on this kid.
So Michael Vick, who's famous because he tortured dogs to death, gets rehired after getting out of jail, and the president thinks that's so exciting that he's going to call the owner of the team to congratulate him for doing it. That was repulsive. That story didn't get the attention it deserved.
That one is shocking. But just to clarify, it's not that the president doesn't have time to call. It's that what he's saying is there are international protocols in place, and the president shouldn't have to cajole and beg other countries to give us back a suspected criminal. That's not how it works.
They should be impressed that he is Barack Obama and he's president of the United States. Just do his will.
We have this process. There is a process, and the other leaders should respect the process.
You know what? The problem is, remember when the president went over to Europe to make sure that he brought home the Olympics? For Chicago, and that blew up in his face, and he didn't do that.
The sad thing is, this was the one thing we were going to get, this and improved race relations. Those are the two things you were going to get out of the Obama presidency. The world will respect us, people will do our bidding, because he is the president.
Transparent president.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry.
The most transparent administration. Sometimes campaign promises don't work out.
But additionally, you know, by the fact that if he asked Putin for something, and Putin, who does not, you know, it's a power struggle between those two guys. Putin would love the opportunity to stick his finger in the president's eye, and he's doing that with this. And if the president is not successful in getting Snowden back, it simply shows the limitations of our president's international influence. It certainly is waning.